Hello everyone. In this session, we will try to discuss about the compound pressure relief valve. Before going in depth with respect to the compound pressure relief valve, first we will know what we have discussed in the earlier, which is nothing but a simple pressure relief valve. The simple pressure relief valve consists of the cylinder, in which cylinder it consists of the puppet. The puppet is in turn pressurized by the spring, and the spring is in turn pressurized by a piston, and that piston, or it may be something like a plunger. That plunger is in turn supported by a screw thread. Now here, once if the pressurized is done by using the screw, automatically the same pressure will be built up on the spring. Once if the spring pressure is increased, automatically the pressure capacity of the, what we can say, the line is also increasing. It in turn the same pressure is built up on the pilot. Once if the same pressure is built up on the pilot, the pressure capacity on the line will also increases. The main difference between the simple pressure relief valve and as well as the compound pressure relief valve is it consists of the two different types of valves. The first one is nothing but a main relief valve. The second one is the pilot relief valve. See, here in the case of the compound pressure relief valve consists of the pilot relief valve, the first, which is operating to a maximum pressures. Once if it is reaches to a maximum, automatically the pilot relief valve will opens. The pressure or the oil which has been passed through under pressure will passes through the main relief valve, and then the same thing is let out to the tank. This is the operation what it is taking place in the case of the compound pressure relief valve. The main advantages of the compound pressure relief valve is it is nothing but it is operated by means of the pilot. The pilot is in turn pressurized by means of the spring. If the small pressures are operated, then what we can say, the pilot relief valve will not in open position. If the pressure is beyond the limit of the, what we can say, the pilot relief valve, automatically the pilot relief valve will opens. Once if the pilot relief valve will opens, automatically the oil which is flowing in the line will passes through the main relief valve, and then afterwards it is flowing into the tank. The pressure drop then causes a piston and as well as stem to lift off their seats, and the flow goes directly from the pressure port to the tank. See, this is a principle what it is working in the case of the compound pressure valve. The advantages with respect to the pilot operated pressure relief valves are over the direct relief valves are here in this case, a large amount of pressures, or it may be a maximum pressures, it can be operated very easily. And here in this case, as we know that there are two different types of valve. One is nothing but a pilot relief valve, the another one is a main relief valve. The safety concern is also the maximum. The component is also a very very simpler when compared to the main relief valve, or it may be a simple relief valve. They have a wider range, and as well as the maximum pressure settings, then direct acting pressure relief valves. They can operate using a remote, while the direct acting pressure relief valves cannot be. See, these are all some of the advantages with respect to the compound relief valve over a simple pressure relief valve. The schematic diagram shows a compound pressure relief valve. The horizontal one is nothing but a pilot relief valve. The vertical one is nothing but a main relief valve. The horizontal one, which consists of the pilot in turn is pressurized by means of a spring. The spring is in turn pressurized by means of a plunger. The plunger is connected with a screw. Once if the screw is tightened, the pressure is developed over the spring. This pressure is in turn applied over the pilot. It means that a large amount of pressure, or the maximum pressures, it can be operated. Then the same line is in turn connected to a, what we can say, the main line. The main line is operated, or is in turn connected to directly to a tank port. Once if the the, what we can say, the pilot relief valve is under open position, the oils which starts flowing through the pilot relief valve, passes through the main relief valve, and then it is passing to the tank port. See, this is an explanation with respect to the compound pressure relief valve. The next part what we are discussing is with respect to the flow control valve. As we discussed the two things, one is a direction control valve, the another one is a pressure relief valve. The third part what we are discussing is nothing but the flow control valve. See, the flow control valve, as the name suggests, that it controls the rate of flow of the fluid through the hydraulic circuits. The flow control valves accurately limits the fluid volume rate and as well as the fixed displacement pump to or from the branch circuit. As you know that even here also the flow control valves are also different types depending upon the type of the application and also the pressures. Even here also it is varying. The functions of the flow control valve is to provide a velocity control and as velocity control of the linear actuator or the speed control of the rotary actuator. If the flow is maximum, the linear movement of the actuator will also be more, and also the speed of the rotary actuator will also be more. If the flow is less, automatically the linear actuator or it may be the rotary actuator speed starts decreasing it. The typical application including the regulating the speed of the actuator or the speed of the rotary actuator, by which it can be used for so many applications, that too especially in the automation field. The flow control valves are classified into non-pressure compensated and also the pressure compensated valve. As you know that the name is suggesting that non-pressure compensated valve. The non-pressure compensated valve or the flow control valve are used when the system pressure is relatively a constant and a moderating speeds are not to be a critical. The operating principle behind these valves is that the flow through the orifice remains constant if the pressure drop across it remains the same, or in other words, the rate of flow through the orifice depends upon the pressure drop across it. As you know that the flow control valve is used to control the speed or in the linear movement of the actuator by using a non-pressure compensated valve. A constant speed it can be achieved, or even the low speeds can be achieved. The main disadvantage of these type of valves are the variations of the pressure. If there is a variations in pressure in the outlet, the pressure it will be more in the inlet. This implies that the flow rate depends upon the workload. Hence, the speed of the piston cannot be defined accurately by using a non-pressure compensated flow control valve. This is extremely a major problem that addresses the hydraulic circuits where the load and as well as the pressure is varying constantly. The schematic diagram shows the non-pressure compensated flow control valve. See, here in this case there are three sketches there. The first one consists of a part, the flow direction A and as well as B. The direction of the flow is from A to B, that is arrested by using the needle. The front portion of the needle is designed something like a pilot. Once a screw pressure is applied, automatically the entire thing, the flow is totally blocked. Once if the screw is unlocked, the oil starts flowing from A to B. If it is totally open, the pressure will also increasing it. See, here in all these three, the pressure is not the main part. As the opening of the screw takes place, the pressure starts increasing it. The first one is nothing but a fully closed position. The second one is nothing but a partially open position. The third one is nothing but a fully open position. See, these are the three sketches which explains how the non-pressure compensated valve works through the needle. The next part what we are discussing is with respect to the pressure compensated flow control valve. See here, the pressure compensated flow control valve, as we know that once if the pressure is increased, along with the pressures, even the temperature will also increases. There are two parameters are coming into picture. The one is the pressure also, it should be compensated. Along with the pressure, even what we can say, the temperature, it also be controlled. These are the two different types of valves which are available in the case of the pressure compensated valve. The first thing what we are discussing is nothing but the basics with respect to the pressure compensated flow control valve. The pressure compensated flow control valve consists of the main spool and as well as the compensator spool. The compensator spool will work first, and then afterwards the main spool will work. The adjustment of the knob and as well as the control of the main spool position, which controls the orifice size at the outlet. The upstream pressure is delivered to the valve by the pilot line A. Similarly, the downstream pressure is controlled by the compensator spool by the pilot line B. These two is operated by means of a spool. The compensated spring biased, the spool is so that it tends towards the fully open position. If the pressure drops across the wall increases, that is the upstream pressure increases relatively the downstream pressure, the compensator spool moves to the right against the force of the spring and then opens the port. This reduces the flow, that in turn reduces the pressure drop and tries to attain an equilibrium position so far as the flow is concerned. Thus, in the flow condition, any pressure drop less than the bias spring force do not affect the fully open compensated orifice, but the pressure drop greater than the bias spring force reduces the compensated orifice. The schematic diagram explains the two things. One is nothing but the compensator spool, and also the another thing is with the, what we can say, the main spool. The first thing is the main the compensator spool is controlled by means of the spring. The main spool is controlled by means of the screw.